Hello and welcome to a new data analysis video from Xset Pro. Today I'll be showing you a very useful tool in what if analysis called data tables. I have already prepared one tutorial which is linked in the description below where I did one variable data analysis where I showed you how you can calculate and forecast future gratuity or indemnity per month even up to 2 years. This time I'll be showing you how to use data tables with two-way variables. As you can see, I have a table set up here where I have units, price per unit, total sales, cost of sales, gross profit, and gross profit margin, fixed cost, and net profit. The margin, it depends on this factor which you can change here. So cost of sales formula is nothing but C7, which is total sales, multiplied by 1 minus profit percentage, which is 15 right now. So it will be multiplying by 0.85 or 85%. So this profit percentage, which is in C10 and C14, should be same. On the right hand side, I have created data table. On horizontal row, we have unit sold quantity. On the vertical row, we have unit price, which is this and this respectively. So what we are trying to do is to figure out what is our maximum profit, or at which level we'll be in profit. Currently we are in loss. As you can see, at unit price of 15 and quantity of 500, there is a loss of $3,875, which you can see here. I have created scroll bars to manipulate quantity, increase the quantity or decrease the quantity, and profit accordingly changes in the table itself. Same way, I have created another scroll bar at per unit price. You can change the unit price and see how your profit will perform. So based on this analysis, if we cannot increase our quantity sold, we have to increase our price to $68 per unit to have a profit, almost break even. While this seems very impractical, one thing we can do is to increase the quantity sold. But if you want to keep price at very lowest, which is $10, you have to increase your quantity sold, which starts at 3600 units. Similar way, you can cross-reference an intersection point where you think you might have the maximum profit. You can also change this particular measure, which is net profit for now, to total sales. And all you can see based on quantity and price, what would be your total sale at different levels. Price and quantity. One more way to increase your profitability without increasing your price or quantity would be to increase our gross margin. So let's change it to 25. As you can see, figures have changed. Now I'll be showing you step by step how to create this kind of analysis from scratch. This is the format I already prepared. We'll start inputting figures here. Let's keep 500 units as our minimum quantity we can sell. Let's keep this time price of $10. Keep the margin low as 15%. And $5,000 as our fixed cost. Now based on this analysis, we'll be creating a data table. So on the horizontal row, we'll be keeping unit sale, which is here. And on vertical row, we'll be keeping price per unit, which is here, sell price. We have to create a link quantity series, which I'll show you how. So let's keep it 500 as minimum. Then we'll be adding 250. Same way, we'll be adding 250 to other levels, like this. Let's keep price 9.5 and increment by 0.5 and so on. Now here in this cell, G5, we have to take the measure. Now which particular factor you want to manipulate and see. So in our case, we want to see net profit performance at various quantity and price level. So you have to link this particular cell in the model itself from where the data is coming. So it is nothing but cell C12. I have named this cell by using name range, which I'll explain you why I did it at a later stage. So we want to maximize our profit at various quantity and price level. Now let's create data table. You have to select your data table area like this. Go to data tab. What if analysis? Data table. So there are two inputs required, raw input cell and column input cell. So raw input cell, you cannot choose from inside this particular table. Most importantly, it should be from the model itself, from where the calculations are coming. So for us, it's nothing but cell C5. And column input is price per unit. So we have to select price, which is here, which is cell C6. And click OK. And here your data table is ready. Now let's create scroll bars so we can manipulate the quantity and price with a click of buttons. So for that, you have to go to Developer tab, which you have to enable by going through File Options, Customize Ribbon, and click on this particular Developer tab here and click OK. Then you will see Developer tab here, just near to View tab. So in there, you have to go to Insert, Form Controls, select scroll bar and draw a horizontal scroll bar like this. Similarly, we create another vertical scroll bar by going to form controls, selecting scroll bar and draw scroll bar like this. So let's set these scroll bars. Currently they are doing nothing at all. So you do right click, form control, and input some values here. So let's input current value 0, minimum value 500, maximum quantity will be choosing 20,000, increment by 250, page change 10, and cell link, cell should be this cell because this is the main input cell and from this other cells are linked. Click OK. Click outside the scroll bar and see, it is active now. As you can see, once you click it, the data is changing. Similarly, you have to set unit price scroll bar controls. 0 would be current value. Minimum value would be 9, maximum value 100 because we don't want to increase that much price. Increment by 1, change by 5, and we have to select cell G6 because this is the particular cell from which other cells are changing in this vertical cell price row. Click OK. As you can see, when you click on these buttons, the price is changing. Now let's try to set this cell G5 as dynamic, as I promised before. Currently it is measuring the net profit, but we also want to measure total sales by changing the drop down menu like this here. To do that, you have to go to your original data and give a name. So currently the total sales cell is C7, but I have named it like this, total sales. And similar way, net profit, which is nothing but column C12, I have named it to net profit. Now you have to use indirect function to get data validation values. First of all, we'll be setting this particular cell as data validation. You have to go to data, data validation, and for the source you have to select names which you have kept here. So same name should be as a stack string here, total sales and net profit, exactly same. Click OK. Now as you can see, the values are here, total sales and net profit. Here we'll be using a formula called indirect and selecting this cell. So based on our selection, the values are changing. For example, total sales is turning to 5000 based on this text value. This is what the indirect function does. As you can see the syntax, it turns your stack string to a reference. So for us, total sales as a name range is equal to cell C7. Similarly, net profit is equal to cell C12. Now with the help of this table, you can quickly analyze what would be your profit or when you start making profit. So your first profit appears at a level of 1500 quantity and price of 22.5. It's almost break even. Similarly, if you keep increasing your price, you'll have a higher margin, higher net profit. Similarly with the quantity. Now, if you don't want to increase this price that much, you can increase your profit like this. So from 15, so let's increase to 25. So you can start making money earlier by selling at 13.5 only instead of 22.5. Increase your margin further to 40. Again, you have to sell lesser quantity and at a lower price. For example, here at 10.5 and quantity of 12.50, you are making $250 profit. Or even if you increase your price to 13, you can start making profit at $1,000. Also, we are reaching break-even points at this two level. Price per unit 10 and 12.50 as quantity, and 1,000 quantity and 12.5. That's where we will be having break-even point. And beyond that, it's profit only. Again, you can change your profit from 40 to 50. And you can reduce the quantity accordingly. And you can see what are the profit results. So this is how you prepare a quick data analysis for any product or service which you want to enter or want to experiment for your organization. And these data tables are really helpful in that. So let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. If you want to have this workbook for your demo purpose, I have a link below where you can download it. I will be bringing more useful data analysis tips and advanced Excel tutorials very soon. Also, I'm coming up with full-fledged Udemy course soon on depreciation calculation analysis with Pro Depreciation Template. So look out for that. I'll be sharing the link on my blog post here on Facebook, YouTube, and on LinkedIn groups. Thanks again for watching. I'll see you in my next video.